Hello friends, welcome to Pediatric Lectures. I'm myself Dr. Sudarshan. Today's topic is the CSF formation, the CSF production, where it is produced, the flow of CSF and the CSF absorption. First thing, you just follow the arrow, you'll come to know everything. Before describing about the CSF, I want to tell about the ventricles. There are two lateral ventricles. This is left and this is the right ventricle. Just follow the cursor. This is the right ventricle and this is the right ventricle. And this is the third ventricle, this is the fourth ventricle. The space which connects the third lateral ventricles, these two are lateral ventricles and third ventricle is foramen of Munro. And the space which connects the third ventricle and fourth ventricle is called as aqueduct of Sylvius. Clear, right? Two lateral ventricles. From lateral ventricle, the third ventricle, the space connecting the lateral ventricles and the third ventricle is, this one is, the space which connects the lateral and third ventricle is foramen of Munro. The space which connects the third ventricle and fourth ventricle is aqueduct of Sylvius. This one, you just remember the names. I will describe about in detail about this thing. This is foramen of Lushka, the lateral side, and foramen of Magendie and Meniere side. This one I will describe later. Before this, now I want to describe about the how CSF is produced. The CSF is produced. See, this curled one is the choroid plexus. The CSF is produced from the choroid plexus. So the choroid plexus are present in the lateral ventricle, third ventricle, fourth ventricle, and even in the spaces which connect the ventricles. So, but the major amount of this choroid plexus is present in the two lateral ventricles, third ventricle and fourth ventricle. But the major amount of CSF is produced from the choroid plexus. If you are preparing for entrance, this is an entrance MCQ. The major amount of CSF is produced from the choroid plexus of the lateral ventricle. Clear, right? The lateral ventricle choroid plexus will produce the major amount of CSF, not the third ventricle or fourth ventricle. This will also produce, but the major is produced from the lateral ventricular choroid plexus. Okay, clear, right? This is the choroid plexus. So the CSF is produced on both ventricles from the choroid plexus. This CSF will transport to the third ventricle through a space called as foramen of Munro. This is the foramen of Munro. Just follow the cursor and come to me. This space is called as the foramen of Munro. From the third ventricle, the fluid will enter into the fourth ventricle through aqueduct of Sylvius. Now it is clear, right? Okay, now you come down. This is the fourth ventricle. From the fourth ventricle, the CSF will enter into the spaces called as foramen of Lushka, and this space is called as foramen of Magendie. This, if you take this one as a ventricle, these are the lateral ones, correct, right? This, both sides are lateral ventricle, looking like hands. These are lateral spaces, and this is the medial space, the small crag. This is the medial side. So the CSF from the fourth ventricle enter these spaces. One is foramen of Lushka in the lateral side, and foramen of Magendie in the medial side. From here, it will enter the arachnoid space. Subarachnoid space, sorry. So from lateral ventricles and the fourth ventricle through lateral spaces and medial spaces, it will enter into the subarachnoid spaces. Clear, right? So basically, lateral ventricle, foramen of Munro, third ventricle, aqueduct of Sylvius, then fourth ventricle, from here through lateral spaces and medial apertures, sorry, it's not spaces, apertures. Through medial and lateral apertures, it is entering into the subarachnoid space. This is the subarachnoid space. You see, the gap between this entire thing is brain, and this is the outer meninges. So the gap between this meninges, this outline is called meninges, and this is the brain. Outline and meninges is subarachnoid space. So from through Lushka and Magendie, the CSF is entering into the subarachnoid space. From here, it will transport to the upside, because the lower side is high pressure and this side is low pressure. From down to upside, from high pressure to lower pressure, it will transport. So the CSF which entered into the subarachnoid space through arachnoid granulations. Here some small holes will be there, those are called as arachnoid granulations on both sides. Through arachnoid granulations, it will enter into the superior sagittal sinus, the sagittal sinuses. Okay, the CSF which is produced here is absorbed through the arachnoid granulations or arachnoid villi into the superior sagittal sinus. Clear, right? I'll fastly tell about this thing. First thing is choroid plexus is produced. Choroid plexus is producing the CSF. From here, it is entering the both side of lateral ventricle. These two ventricles will produce the CSF. From in two ventricles through choroid plexus, if CSF is produced, from here it will enter the third ventricle through foramen of Monroe. From here, it is entering into the fourth ventricle through aqueduct of Sylvius. In the fourth, from fourth ventricle through foramen of Magenta in the middle side and foramen of Luschka in the lateral side, will enter into the subarachnoid space. From the subarachnoid space, it will reach the superior part of the brain. In the superior part, through arachnoid villi and arachnoid granulations, the CSF is absorbed into the superior sagittal sinuses. Cerebrospinal fluid. Cerebro means brain, spinal is the spinal cord. I explained entirely about the cerebro means the brain part. Next thing is the remaining amount of CSF will enter down to the spinal cord. This is the foramen of magnum. The spinal cord enters through foramen. Brain continues as the spinal cord through foramen of magnum. This is the foramen. From the spinal cord, in the spinal cord there is a canal, CSF canal. The CSF will pass through the canal. Okay. The major amount of CSF is absorbed through the choroid villi or choroid granulations. Okay. Then minor amount will be carried by the some cranial nerves will transport from the brain here. This is the brain. From here the cranial nerves will transport. Surrounding the cranial nerve there will be lymphatics. So little amount of CSF is absorbed to the lymphatics of the cranial nerves and little amount from the lymphatics of the spinal nerves also. The spinal nerves lymphatics also will absorb little amount. Clear, right? The major amount of current now MCQs are the major amount of choroid plexus is major amount of CSF is produced from the choroid plexus of lateral ventricles. The major absorption is through arachnoid villi and arachnoid granulations into the arachnoid villi and arachnoid granulations. This is the superior sagittal into the superior sagittal sinus. And the lateral apertures of our fourth ventricle is foramen of Luschka, and the medial apertures of our fourth ventricle is foramen of Magenta. This much question they will ask commonly. Clear, right? Now